Hello people, welcome to Gurukula. This is Jai, and so today in this video we are gonna see about two models to determine the path loss. So that is log distance model and then the log normal shadowing model. So we will see what are all the drawbacks of the previous model, whatever we have derived so far, and then we will see what is the difference between the previously derived model and as well as the log distance and log normal model which we are going to see today. So without any further delay, let us get into the video, and please do let me know your feedback by liking and disliking the video, and if you have any comments, please do let me know in the comment section so that I will come to know what you are thinking about the videos. So without any further delay, let's get into the topic now. So first of all, to get introduced with the topic, and we already know that there are two approaches for formulating a path loss model. So it can be either formulated by using pure analytical approach, or it can be formulated by using empirical approach. Analytical approach, we will be modeling the entire path loss model only by using the mathematical equations and certain assumptions. The empirical approach is nothing but the path loss will be modeled by the actual physical measurements in various environments, and then we will take multiple number of values, and with those values or data I will be fitting a curve by considering all the known and then unknown parameters in the environment. And while discussing in the basic terms, we concluded that the empirical approach is not so practical, so that we always go for an analytical approach. So now today in this video we will see what happens if I take the path loss model if it is purely derived by using analytical approach. So modeling and path loss model is not an important task. It is equally important to validate the model whatever been derived by using analytical approach in various environments with our required frequency of transmission, and we need to evaluate the model whatever we have derived, whether it satisfies our frequency of transmission or our transmission parameters. So that is also equally important, which will be addressed in this log normal and then log distance shadowing model. So the path loss model also enables us to predict not only the path loss, but also we can estimate the signal to noise ratio, the noise floor, and then the capacity in space spectrums as well. So most of the advanced path loss models that we have nowadays will let us know to calculate what are all the SNR, noise floor, and then the capacity of space spectrum as well. And the pure analytical approach path loss models are a little bit inaccurate because of many immature assumptions what we made just in order to reduce the derivation complexity. So while deriving both the models, means the free space model and as well as the two-ray model, while deriving we have made quite a lot of assumptions. We could say that all the assumptions what we made are immature assumptions which we are not going to see in any of the practical situations, but still we made all those assumptions and then we formulated the equation for path loss. So actually this particular area is where it brings in a necessity to design a path loss model which is more realistic by considering some practical scenarios into account. So this is the area where the log normal shadowing approach and log distance approach will have an upper hand. The practical link budget design using path loss model. So we will be taking the path loss models whatever we have derived so far for as a reference, and we will see how to derive this particular model in log distance and as well as log normal shadowing. So these two models, means the log distance path loss model and log normal shadowing model, have been developed in order to eliminate the drawbacks of the path loss models whatever we have derived so far. To start off with, let me start off with log distance path loss model. So when we consider the path loss models we have formulated so far, path loss models for free space equation and then two-ray model, it is clearly noted that the received signal power decreases logarithmically over distance. So this is an equation, or this will be the path loss equation what we derived for free space equation. And this is an path loss equation what we derived for two-ray model. So in both of the situations, when you observe the equations very carefully, the path loss is getting degraded on a logarithmic scale over distance. For free space, it is d power 2, and for 2-ray model, the path loss is getting degraded in on a logarithmic scale over d power 4. So what log distance path loss model gives us is the general path loss equation is completely dependent on the transmitter receiver separation. So the equation can be generalized as, so PL of D is directly proportional to D by D naught of N, sorry, D by D naught power N. So here the PL represents the path loss equation, which is directly proportional to the distance, where D is the actual distance between transmitter and then the receiver, and D naught is nothing but the reference distance or close-in distance, whatever we term. And so this particular term to the power N, and where N represents path loss exponent, which can be also written as, by eliminating that proportional symbol, so PL of D can be written as PL of D is equals to PL of D naught plus 10 times N log of D over D naught. So wherever you can see the bars on a particular variable, that represents that variable is an ensembled averaged values. So ensembled averaged values is nothing but I can calculate this PL of D either by using free space model equation or 2-ray model equation. This particular PL will be calculated either by using these two equations depending upon the environment, and the measurements will be made on different environment, and then all those values will be averaged together. And then I will be taking the final value for PL of D. So doing so will have an more accurate values rather than simply calculating on simulation environments. And so D naught, we already know that is an reference distance, or sometimes we call it as in close-in distance, and N represents the path loss exponent. And when this particular model, this model we have developed by using analytical approach, and this analytically approached equation have been experimented on different environment in order to find out what will be the N value for different environment. And this particular table summarizes what we got for different environment. So when we measure this particular equation on a free space, we ended up with the path loss exponent value as 2, and which quietly satisfies with this equations as well. So obviously we need to get 2, and we got 2 over here. And in some urban areas it ended up with 2.7 to 3.5, and shadowed urban region it ended up with 3 to 5. And in buildings which has a line of sight communication, the path loss exponent is really very low, that is 1.6 to 1.8. And for the obstructed buildings we have 4.6, and then obstructed factories we will have 2 to 3. So in general, what we can conclude from this particular tabulation is the path loss exponents depends on the specific environment, meaning the path loss cannot be defined, or path loss will not be dependent only on the distance between transmitter and then the receiving antenna. So that will be the main drawback, which is not considered in this log distance path loss model. So looking at the equation we have considered, or we have written the path loss equation only by considering the distance between the transmitter and then the receiver. So which is actually not true, the path loss will be varied depending upon the environment as well. So that will be the major drawback of this log distance path loss model, and this drawback will be eliminated in the next model what we are going to study. So that is log normal shadowing path loss model. And also the reference distance will usually be in a range of 1 kilometer when it is an outdoor environment, and it will be ranging from 1 meter to 100 meters for indoor communications. So this is all about the log distance path loss model, and the drawback what we have seen here will be eliminated in the next model. So when you consider a log normal shadowing path loss model, so this will overcome the drawbacks whatever we have in the log distance model. So in log distance model we did not consider the surrounding environment clutter. So environment clutter, there will be huge variations in the received power depending upon the environments as well. So the empirical methods have shown that the environment clutter will be vastly different at two different locations which has the same transmitter receiver separation. Say for an example, when the transmitter receiver separation is kept constant, and then one side I have hilly areas and the other side I have building areas, so the received power of both the signal will not be the same. So that is the meaning for the log normal shadowing path loss model, which means that the environment will also contribute in deciding the path loss. So log normal distribution describes the random shadowing effects as well. You know what shadowing is? Shadowing is the rapid fluctuations which is happening because of obstacles in between transmitter and then the receiver. And then the shadowing effect will be a random one, which will not be uniform in all the cases. So that is the reason why it is considered as random shadowing effect. So which occurs over a large number of measurement locations, which has the same transmitter receiver separation. So but will have different levels of cutter on the propagation path. So actually this phenomena, considering this random shadowing effect, is what is referred to as log normal shadowing. And the log normal shadowing model proposes that for any value of d, the path loss is a random and then it is distributed log normally about a mean distance dependent. So when you look at the equation, it will be very clear that according to log normal shadowing path loss model, the path loss can be represented as the path loss with respect to d, which is actually the same what we had in the log distance model. But in addition to this path loss that is with respect to d, we are having another variable, that is x sigma. So we can see that this PL of d is nothing but the same equation what we have seen in the log distance model. So the log normal shadowing model considers the path loss which we got in the log distance model as such, but in addition to this particular distance, they are also considering the x sigma value, where x sigma is nothing but the zero mean Gaussian distributed random variable with a standard deviation. So x sigma is nothing but this is a random variable. The reason why this is a random variable is the shadowing effect is going to be in random. So in order to consider the shadowing effect, we cannot add a constant over here, and obviously I need to add a random variable here. So this x sigma is a random variable. So when I say a variable is a random, it is mandatory to represent the mean, standard deviation, and as well as the distribution as well. So everything is mentioned over here. So x sigma will have a zero mean and it is distributed in a Gaussian distribution or random distribution, so with a standard deviation sigma. Usually in general cases, the values such as d naught, path loss exponent n, and standard deviation will be fed to a computer simulation environment to calculate the received power at different locations. Mostly all the received power levels will be calculated on the simulation environment. So all these variables such as reference distance, path loss exponent, and standard deviation will be given to the system, and the system will be computed, and the system will in return give us the value for the received power. But in the practical situations, in order to reduce the error, what is done is the path loss exponent and standard deviations are actually measured in the real-time environment, and then those measured data will be given to the system by using linear regression. So by doing this, we can say that it will reduce the error between the measured value and then the estimated path loss. So as per the log normal shadowing, the path loss variable is a random variable. It is not a constant one now because of the addition of that x sigma value. So the random variable can either be estimated or it can be predicted. So thus the received power is always expressed in terms of Q function or in terms of error function. So we cannot frame an equation as such in the previous model, such as a free space model and then the Touré model. We cannot come down to an expression that shows the path loss in some particular terms related to heights of the antenna and as well as PTG, TGR. So this cannot be represented in that form. The reason is that the path loss is now a random variable because we are considering the random effects of shadowing as well. So since the randomness is also considered, my received power will be expressed only in terms of Q function or in terms of error function. So we all know that the Q function, the quality function equation, the general form of quality function equation, is given by 1 over root of 2 pi integral z over z to infinity e to the power minus of x squared by 2 times dx, which can be also be written as Q of z is equals to 1 by 2 times 1 minus erf of z by root of 2. where ERF is nothing but the error function and QZ is nothing but the quality function. And this is the relation between Q function and as well as the ERF function. And when I wanted to know what will be the received power within before a reference distance and after a reference distance, so which can be defined by an expression where PR is nothing but the received power, which will be represented in an Q function such as Q of gamma minus PR of D over sigma. And when I wanted to find out the received power beyond this particular area, then I can calculate by using this particular expression. So this is how my received power can be expressed in terms of Q function, and Q function can be related to error function by using this relationship. And now we will see a little proof that how I can actually write the received power in terms of Q and then in terms of ERF. So now consider this particular slide. Now this is what the actual equation, what our log normal shadowing model gives us, and we know that the x sigma is nothing but zero mean Gaussian distributed random variable, and the distribution graph for the Gaussian distribution can be given like this, where m stands for the mean and x stands for the difference. And the general equation for Gaussian distribution can be written as 1 divided by sigma root of 2 pi e to the power minus of x minus m the whole square divided by 2 sigma squared. So this will be the general expression for the Gaussian distribution. But I am very much interested to find out what will be the received power after a reference distance, beyond a reference distance. So I will take a reference distance here as x naught, and I am very much interested to find out what will be the received power of this particular area, the shaded region. So I can happily rewrite the general equation as like this. I need the received power, PR stands for the received power, and I'm very much interested to calculate PR of received power in this particular region, where beyond x naught and until x will be equal to integral of x naught to infinity, from x naught to infinity, and the same equation whatever we have seen over here, which is integrated with respect to x. And now we cannot directly integrate this particular equation in a closed form, so we will go for the substitution method. In the substitution method, let me take y is equals to x minus m divided by sigma. So when I take y is equals to x minus m divided by sigma, the above equation can be rewritten as PR of y greater than x naught minus m divided by sigma is equals to integral of x minus m divided by sigma up to infinity 1 divided by root of 2 pi e to the power minus of y square divided by 2. And the sigma will be equated to 1. Why? Because this is done for the normalization. We have assumed that x sigma is an zero mean Gaussian distribution with the standard deviation. So since the mean is 0, I will take m is equals to 0, and the standard deviation value I am taking it as 1. This is done only for the normalization purposes. So in those cases I will be ending up with this particular expression. And fortunately, this integral term can be designated as Q function. So this is the basic equation for the Q function. And so what I can do is I can write Q of z is equals to integral z to infinity 1 divided by root of 2 pi and e to the power minus y squared by 2 times dy. So this is an Q function. When we consider all the right hand sides are equal, I can equate the left hand sides as well. So left hand side we have P of y greater than d naught minus m, x naught minus m divided by sigma is equals to Q of x naught minus m divided by sigma, which is equals to Q of z. So this is how I can relate the received power in terms of Q function as well. So that is what the equations what we got in the previous slide. So PR of y that is less than some reference value is taken like this, and PR value which is greater than the reference value, sorry, this is a typo error which is actually supposed to be like this, will be given by this particular equation. And now we will march forward, and then we will see how Q function is related to ERF, that means your error function. So this is an basic equation for error function. So error function of z is given by 2 divided by root of pi integral 0 to z e to the power minus x squared dx, And the complementary error function of z is given by 2 divided by root of pi integral z to infinity e to the power minus x squared divided by e to the power minus x squared times dx. And we also know that the q function is given by this equation, which is already mentioned. And now we are very much interested to equate or to relate this q of z in terms of erf or erfc. When we look at the limits of q function, the limits of q function runs from z to infinity. And so fortunately, erfc equation's integral is also the same, z to infinity. So I will try to take this particular equation. I'll try to take this particular equation and then I will relate. So when I rewrite the equation of, when I compare these two equations, the x squared can be equated to y squared by 2. So x squared can be equated to y squared by 2, from which I can get x is equals to y divided by root 2. And from this, I can calculate dx is equals to dy divided by root 2. And when I want the value of dy, so dy can be written as root 2 times dx. So this is obtained. This is a straightforward derivation from the simple comparison between these two equations. And when I try to rewrite this particular equation with all these substituted values, so 2 by root pi integral of z to infinity e to the power, instead of x squared I have y squared divided by 2, so I will write y squared divided by 2, and then instead of dx I have dy by root 2, so dy by root 2 have been written over here. And then by further simplifying this, by taking the root 2 outside, what I will get is, so root of 2 divided by root of pi integral z to infinity e to the power minus y squared times dx. So in order to make this equation look so similar to q function, this constant has to be somehow converted to 1 divided by root of 2 pi. So just for the sake of bringing this constant same, let me multiply 1 by 2 on both sides. So multiplying this equation by 1 by 2, what I will get is, so 1 by 2 times of this particular entire equation. So this entire equation I have been given over here, and this entire equation is nothing but this is an erfc of z by root 2. So this is an equation for erfc of z by root 2, and if I cancel out these 2 and divided by root 2, I will be ending up with 1 divided by root of 2 pi integral z to infinity e to the power minus y square divided by 2. And this equation is nothing but this is the q function, so q of z. So now you can clearly observe that this particular equation and this particular equation are the same. And we brought this particular equation by representing erfc in terms of substitutions. So from this we can relate that q of z can be related to erfc of thing. So from this particular relation, the q of z can be represented in terms of error function as well. And the error function and complementary error function is related, like, so error function of z is equals to 1 minus complementary error function of z. So that is a very simple relation between error function and complementary error function. So I can represent, I have a freedom of representing q function in terms of erf and as well as erfc. So that is a little proof for how we got this particular expression over here. So that's the end of the video. So in this video, I hope you might have understood what log normal shadowing model and then log distance model, and by comparing the free space equation and then the two-ray model, we just framed out what will be the received power for the log normal method and then the log distance model. So thank you for watching. So if you like this video, do press like and then the unlike button, and consider subscribing to the channel, and happy learning.